Father Peter Mary Mermier was born on August 28, 1790 at Savoy, France. His parents, Francis Mermier and Antoinette Bastien, were wealthy farmers and were held in great respect. 1790. France was besieged with a reign of terror. Public worship was forbidden and even churches were destroyed.
Peter's parents were deeply religious people. They often risked their lives and property by welcoming the priests who were hunted down by the revolutionaries. On Sundays, a priest in secrecy celebrated Holy Mass in their house. It was during this period that young Peter saw his mother pray so devoutly, which made a deep impression on him. The faith and courage of his mother and of those daring priests motivated him to make a decisive choice for the Lord. Mrs. Mermier was not an ordinary woman. On her own initiative, she opened a school and taught Peter, Louis, and even the neighboring children reading, writing arithmetic, and above all, catechism. Young Peter would top his class and already manifested the desire of becoming a priest, and his mother encouraged him in this pursuit.
Year 1800. Religious peace was once again restored in Savoy. In 1801, Miss Mermier took Peter to the Presbyterian College of Villiers de Bouveret, where he continued his studies. After his secondary school, Peter completed his seminary studies and was ordained a priest on 21st March 1813. He was very young and weak as compared with his companions, but he relied on prayer and hard work.
From the very beginning, Father Mermier showed signs of austerities. He wanted everything to be simple. He wished to have a room without any kind of decorations. He did not want a crucifix of gold, but of simple wood, one in which the face of Christ was most expressive. Simplicity and humility guided his nature. His speech and even his gestures were not frivolous. Father Mermier exercised his apostolate very seriously.
Monseigneur de Thiolès, Bishop of Annecy, appointed him spiritual director at the major seminary in 1823. But in 1826, the bishop permitted him to dedicate himself entirely to the mission.
Father Mermier was appointed the parish priest of Châtelard, a large and important parish, when he was just 30 years old. Here, his main aim was an all-round reform, both among the clergy and the faithful. Bishop Ray, too, helped him to establish this missionary activity. Communities were gradually showing signs of reform. Parishioners who harbored hatred and bitterness, and which divided towns and even families, gradually fell in line.
Father Mermier had now two activities in mind, that of a missionary and of a founder. He was on the lookout for a larger house to accommodate his religious family. Encouraged by Bishop Ray, he bought a plot called La Fule. Prayer and construction went together. And on 8th August 1837, Bishop Ray solemnly blessed the new house of the future missionaries of St. Francis de Sales. On the 24th of October 1838, Bishop Ray officially established the congregation of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales. He also gave them three maxims, namely, study the life of St. Francis de Sales, imitate his virtues, and show kindness to the poor sinners.
After the establishment of the congregation of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales, Father Mermier turned his attention to improving the conditions of the youth, and in particular, the young girls belonging to the poor class. In 1837, Father Mermier preached missions at Chavanon, where he came into contact with Claudine Echenier, who wanted to live a humble, recollected life devoted to the apostolate of the poor in 1837. This resulted in the founding of the Congregation of the Sisters of the Cross of Chavanoux for the education of the needy girls.
On the 4th of November 1841, Bishop Ray gave a letter of approbation by which he constituted the Daughters of the Cross as a religious association. Father Mermier founded the Congregation of the Missionaries of St. Francis de Sales for parish mission, foreign mission, and education of the youth. His missionary zeal impelled him to ask the Holy Father for a mission abroad and accept a vast mission territory in India when the congregation was in its infancy with just 11 professed members. With regard to education, he opines that one has to be a mother to the pupil by one's tenderness and a father by one's prudence.
Between 1828 and 1857, Father Mermier himself conducted 90 missions. He considered sermon as the chief means of proclaiming the Word of God. He adopted carefully prepared simple preaching. He spoke with faith and conviction. He guided the missionaries to live a life of kindness and charity in their apostolic ministry and daily relationship with the people. He considered devotion to Our Lady of Seven Sorrows to be an eminent Salesian devotion.
In May 1845, Cardinal Franzoni, the prefect of the propaganda, confided in the young congregation of Annecy the mission territory of Visakhapatnam in India. Accordingly, Father Mermier went ahead with the preparations. On the 8th of June 1845, four priests, namely Father Martin, Father Leverell, Father Jean-Marie Tissot, and Father Jean Thévenet, along with Brother Perry and Brother Supplice, sailed for India. They reached Pondicherry after almost 3 months. After initially overcoming a few difficulties, they seriously began their activities. Father Mermier kept a regular contact with these missionaries. News of their difficulties and successes was periodically communicated to him through letters, which took about 40 days to reach their destination.
To Father Mermier, nothing could be more important than the Holy Mass. Even in the poorest of health and declining eyesight, he wanted to continue his priestly function of celebrating the Mass. As complete blindness set in, he could only attend the Mass and no longer celebrate it. The last days of Father Mermier were full of hardships. His declining health had rendered him incapable of speech and understanding, confining him to the bed and heavily dependent on others. He did not complain of his condition being so. He thought, like St. Francis de Sales, that Jesus performed his greatest act of service when he was laid upon the cross.
Father Mermier had indeed worked hard and his health was becoming poor. On 4th June 1858, he was in agony for 4 weeks, but he resigned himself to the will of God. Gradually, his sight began to fail him. Then on 6th of June 1860, he had again a stroke. In spite of these great hardships, he received with joy the joyful and consoling news from Rome regarding the approval and establishment of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales as a congregation with simple vows. By this time, the congregation was allowed to take up missions in England.
Even at the age of 68 and suffering immeasurably, Father Mermier accepted physical challenges before him and moved on. Parallels can be drawn between the trials faced by Jesus Christ and Father Peter Mermier's own suffering.
While Jesus was crowned with thorns, Father Mermier had to go through the trial of fire through his sickness. In spite of having served the Lord to the best of his ability, it is through his tribulations that Father Mermier realized and understood the suffering of Jesus himself. Nevertheless, he surrendered himself totally to the will of God.
On the 10th of August 1862, he had a very nasty fall, which caused a double fracture on his right leg. He had to lay motionless on his poor straw mattress. His agony lasted for quite some time. On the morning of 30th September 1862, towards 9 o'clock, consumed with suffering, he calmly slept in the peace of the Lord. Bishop Magnin led the humble superior of the missionaries of St. Francis de Sales to his last dwelling place in the burial vault of La Fule.
Father Mermia firmly believed that education is a work of love and that it is incomplete without a religious formation. According to him, education of the heart is the heart of education. He envisaged an educational program marked by respect for children. He expected from the pupils three things: knowledge, wisdom, and discipline.
His achievements are unparalleled. While he was given charge of a small area of France, he spread out his arms of compassion to the farthest shores in India. His accomplishments are of the highest caliber as he emerged out to be a true and devoted follower of the gentleman saint, St. Francis de Sales. His missionaries of St. Francis de Sales have not only succeeded in bringing education to India, but also succeeded in embedding themselves and imbibing the local culture, thus enriching both Eastern and Western cultures.
In India, it has spread across 6 provinces and more than 1,000 members run its hundreds of educational and social service institutions.
A symbol of humility, working for humanity. This is the story of Father Peter Mary Mermier, the journey of a visionary.